Hello everyone, welcome you all for the lecture session on the subject of dynamics of machines. So far in the subject of dynamics of machines, under the module 1 that we are studying, that is governors and gyroscope, you have learnt the concepts with respect to the governors that was taken by the sessions of Professor Abhishek sir and Professor Santosh sir. So you have understood the concept of governors, how the governors are going to work, and specifically you have seen two different type of governors. One is called as an gravity or the deadweight controlled governors, and the other one is an spring controlled governor. The typical examples were the Porter governor as well as an Hartnell governor. Now coming for the next part of this particular module, that is all about gyroscope. Remember, there is no relationship between the governors and the gyroscopes. Both are entirely the different devices, whereas the governors are used for the regulating of a mean speed of an engine for varying loading conditions, whereas the gyroscope we will be learning from this session. So how do we define this term gyroscope, or how do we call the term the gyroscope? Basically, this word gyre is a Greek word which means to say that it is in circular motion. So the Greek word gyre means circular motion. And now, in order to define the gyroscope, gyroscope is defined as a device which is consisting of a disc or a wheel mounted so that it can spin rapidly about an axis which itself is free to alter in its direction. So looking into this standard definition, we cannot make out what is a gyroscope is, or how the device look like, or how it is going to work. The other definition for a gyroscope is a body which will spin about an axis and it is free to alter in its direction whenever it is acted upon by an external force. So now also we cannot understand the concept of gyroscope. So in order to make it clear, let us take an example of a spinning top. See, whenever we keep a top on any table, it will be falling off. If you provide a certain momentum for it, it will be rotating on the tabletop. On what principle it is working? Because of the rotation that you are given, it is working. Similarly, the gyroscope consists of a disc or wheel that is mounted, and it will be rotating continuously, and it is free to move or alter in its direction whenever it is acted upon by an external force. So the top will be spinning on the table. When you provide some amount of force, it will alter in its direction. Similarly, the gyroscope works. So it will consisting of a wheel or a disc which is mounted, and it will be spinning at certain speed, and whenever you apply some amount of force, they are used in order to change in its direction, or they are allowed in order to change in its direction. Where all we can see this application of a gyroscope? See, this gyroscope majorly used in the application of gyrocompass. This gyrocompass are predominantly used in almost all the sectors. For example, the gyrocompass are used in the navigations of for the naval ships, for the aeroplanes in order to change in its direction. And not only there, they are also used in the space shuttles, in the navigation system, in the control system of the missiles, in the ballistic missiles. So in all the cases, we can see the applications of gyrocompass. Even in our mobile phones, we can see the application of gyrocompass sensors, where they are used for the location, the navigation purpose, and even the direction. In order to indicate the direction, the gyrocompass sensors are used. Another big example is in the Hubble telescope, where in order to maintain the position of a Hubble telescope, the effect of the gyroscope has been considered. Not only with respect to the gyrocompass, they also used in order to maintain the stability of in vehicles. Which vehicles? It could be either the two-wheeler or it could be the four-wheeler. We can see the application of a gyroscope. So we can clearly state that the gyroscope finds its application in almost all the sectors. Even in the launching satellites, we can see the trajectory of a satellite with the help of this gyrocompass, basically a gyroscope device. Now, before coming for the effect of the gyroscope on the plane disc, aeroplane and the naval ship that we will be discussing in this session. Let us try to understand the terms that are associated with respect to the gyroscopic effect. So, as I said, the gyroscope consisting of a disc or a wheel which will be rotating about in axis, that is OX. So the OX is representing the axis. This doesn't have any meaning unless we are specifying the observer. Where is the observer? So this wheel is mounted and it is spinning about its axis and it has its own velocity. So we know that velocity is a vector quantity. We know that scalar is an vector will have only the magnitude, whereas the velocity vector will have the magnitude as well as the direction. So in order to have both, we should show the direction and in which direction it is acting. So here the axis OX is representing the axis of spin. The OX is representing the axis of spin in which the disc is mounted, and this disc is rotating in the clockwise direction and the observer is from here. The disc is rotating in the clockwise direction and the observer is from here. So this is with respect to the axis of spin. On which direction the force is applied in order to alter this direction, that is the axis of couple. On in which direction it tries to precess or in which direction it tries to move, it is called as the axis of precession. So the axis of spin is represented by the vector OX. The axis of precession is represented by the vector OY. The axis of couple is, or the torque that is applied for this change in direction, is represented by the vector OZ. So these three parameters are essential in order to understand the concept of the gyroscopic effect. The planes also has been represented in order to make it clear. So it will be acting, the axis of spin will be acting along this plane of OX. Similarly, the axis of precession, in which direction this wheel tries to move, is represented in this plane, and the axis of couple is represented in which the plane or the torque is applied for this wheel to change in its direction. So this is with respect to the basic terms that we are supposed to remember in order to understand the effect of gyroscope. Now we'll see how the effect of gyroscope will act on the plane disc. Now, before understanding the effect of a gyroscope on a plane disc, we should be familiarized with the basic concepts of something called as momentum, or basically a linear momentum. So how do we define the linear momentum of a particle? So linear momentum of a particle is defined as the product of mass into its velocity. This we have already studied in our lower semester classes. So it's a product of mass into its velocity. And remember, this linear momentum, or basically a momentum, is also a vector quantity, and the direction is sense will be same as that of the velocity. So this is with respect to linear momentum. Then how do we define the term called as angular momentum? This angular momentum is defined as the moment of linear momentum. Now we know a particle which is traveling in a straight line, but now we are supposed to give it a circular motion, that is an angular momentum. So in order to define angular momentum, we know the relation as the moment of linear momentum. So the linear momentum is given by mass into its velocity into its radius will give us the value of angular momentum. So basically we know that the velocity will be equal to the angular speed into its radius of rotation. Now replacing the term of V with respect to omega into R. So m omega R into R will give us the value of m omega R square, where m into R square is nothing but the mass moment of inertia. I am replacing m R square by the term called as I, and omega as it is I am replacing. So the angular momentum in general is given by I omega. What is I? I is called as mass moment of inertia, which is equals to m into r square, where omega is the angular speed of rotation. So with this fundamental of linear momentum and angular momentum, now let us proceed with the gyroscopic effect on the plane disc. How a gyroscope will have an effect on the plane disc. So in order to understand this concept, I have taken a plane disc which is mounted on the shaft, and the shaft is placed in between the bearings. So the shaft is rotating and the disc that is mounted on the shaft is also in the rotation. So we know that on which axis the disc is mounted, that axis we are going to call it as the axis of spin or the spin axis. In this sketch, x, x dash will represent the spin axis. The x, x dash will represent the spin axis, the vector Ox in the case of a basic terms. So x, x dash will represent the spin axis. Now, in order to make this disc to change in its position, to change in its angular momentum, we are supposed to apply the torque or the couple, and that is applied with respect to the axis of z, z dash. That is nothing but couple axis. So this is couple axis. On which direction this disc will be rotated? On which direction this disc will be rotated? That axis we are going to call it as precession axis. That axis we are going to call it as precession axis. And remember, the precession axis will be perpendicular to spin axis and the couple axis. So this precession axis will be perpendicular to spin axis and the couple axis, whereas the precession axis will be, the precession axis will be perpendicular to spin and the couple axis, whereas the couple axis will be perpendicular to the spin axis. So basically, spin axis, the couple axis will be perpendicular to the spin axis. The axis of precession will be perpendicular to both spin axis as well as a couple axis. In order to explain over here, so this is the axis of spin. Perpendicularly, the couple is applied. So since I cannot push into the board, we are presented over here. The OZ will be perpendicular to OX, and the OY will be perpendicular to both OX and OZ. So this is with respect to the concepts or the terms that are with respect to the plane disc. Now, when the disc is rotating, with an angular velocity of omega, so let us give a small change in its direction. That is, it has displaced through a distance of delta theta. The momentum of this disc is changed through a small angular displacement of delta theta. And see, that is, it is trying to move towards the precession axis. Now, we know that angular momentum of any disc is given by I omega. The angular momentum is given by I omega, where I is called the moment of inertia, mass moment of inertia, omega is the angular speed of rotation. Here, there is a change in angular momentum, is it not? The disc was initially on the spin axis. We have applied some couple to change in its direction. So that is given by change in angular momentum. So that is I omega delta theta. There is some amount of change in its direction with respect to the time. So the rate of change in angular momentum is given by I omega delta theta by delta t. Now from the principles of the mathematics, so applying limits as delta t tends to 0, this delta theta by delta t will becomes I omega into d theta by dt, where this term d theta by dt is called as the precession velocity that is represented by the term omega p. So this term d theta by t, dt is called as an precision velocity that is denoted by the term omega p. So basically the applied gyroscopic couple or the gyroscopic couple which will be acting on the plane disc will be equal to I omega omega p, where I is called the mass moment of inertia, omega is called the angular speed of rotation, omega p will be equal to the precession velocity. So that is what we have written over here. So I is the mass moment of inertia mr square, omega is the angular velocity, we can calculate using the relation of 2 pi n divided by 60, where omega p is the precision velocity, which is given by v divided. In general, it is denoted by v divided by r. So this is the effect of gyroscope on a plane disc. The general expression, whether it is a plane disc, whether it is an aeroplane, whether it is a naval ship, the gyroscopic couple, the amount of gyroscopic couple will be equal to I omega omega p. So from now onwards, whenever we use the term gyroscopic couple, we know the value is I omega omega p. Using this relations, we can identify the effects on the aeroplane and in the naval ship. So now let us try to consider the effect of the gyroscopic couple on the case of aeroplane. We have understood the concept of the gyroscopic effect on the plane disc. Now, taking up the effect on an aeroplane. So, this is just a representation of an aeroplane in its two view, whether it is in top view or in the case of a front view. So, with considering this conditions of a top and the front view, we will be analyzing how the effect of gyroscope will be acting whenever an aeroplane is taking an direction, whether it is taking a left turn direction or it is taking a right turn direction. So, in order to understand this, let us get familiarized with a few of the terms that are used. So, the direction of view that I have kept is from the tail end. So, if we consider this as an aeroplane, the direction of view that we have considered is from the tail end. And the front portion is called as a nose end. And this nose end houses for the propeller, and this propeller will be rotating one. So, this is not a modern aircraft. This was in earlier days. So, where the propeller used to be at the front of an aeroplane. So, that propeller we have drawn over here. This propeller will be in action of spin. So, if the viewing is from here and the propeller could run either in the clockwise direction or in the anti-clockwise direction. So, I am supposed to specify whether the propeller will be running in clockwise or in the counterclockwise direction. So, the other part that we should know is the axis of spin. So, this indicates the axis of spin over which the propeller is running. And the direction which tries it to precess is the axis of precision, whether it could take the left turn or it could take the right turn. So that axis we are going to call it as axis of precision. So if I recall, it was OX is the vector that was representing the axis of a spin, and OY is the vector that was representing the axis of precision. In order to change this happen, we should apply the couple that is along the axis of OZ. So here OX represents the axis of spin, OY is representing the axis of precision. So now imagine the observer is at the tail end of an aeroplane and the propeller is running in the clockwise direction. So in order to represent the vector, in order to make it simple, let us make use of the right hand thumb rule, which states that the thumb will indicates the direction in which the vector quantity or the velocity is acting, and the other fingers will indicate the sense in which it is rotating. So now if I want to make this propeller to run in the clockwise direction, so I should write the observer is here. This is my axis of spin or the direction in which it is acting, and it is running in clockwise direction. So my fingers should be curl enough. So this is indicating the clockwise direction. So if I curl like this, it will indicate the direction in which the vector is acting. So this is a right hand thumb rule which makes us to solve the problem in a simple fashion. Suppose if it was an anti-clockwise, the finger would have been reversed. So now you can see the vector is changed in its direction. So depending upon the viewer, whether it is viewing from the rear end and the nose end, even the direction of view also changes. So be careful. Now the direction of view is from the tail end and the propeller is running in the clockwise direction. And this aeroplane can take either left turn or right turn. We will see different conditions when it takes either the left turn or the right turn, what will happen and how the gyroscopic effect will be. So in order to do that, we should be familiarized with the three terms which are in which direction the propeller is running. So we know that the propeller is running in the clockwise direction. In which direction of view we are viewing? We are viewing from the tail end. And what is the turn that is taking? So it is, the aeroplane is taking a left turn. So how to draw the effect with respect to these conditions? So the first condition is I am viewing from the tail end. So I am, the observer is here and the propeller is running in the clockwise direction. So curl the fingers, it is running in the clockwise direction. In which direction the vector is acting or the axis of spin is acting? So the thumb indicates that. So if I write that, this is the point where I am observing. And the vector is acting in this direction. So the OX will indicate us the axis of spin, that is the OX vector. Now, which direction it has to precess? It has to take the left turn. Here, we are here. So it is running in clockwise and the direction of vector or the axis of spin. It has to take left turn. So if I take the left turn, you can clearly observe the thumb is moving upward. So the axis of precision in which direction? It is in upward direction. Now I am representing the axis of precision. So I can represent the vector axis of precision, and we know OY represents the axis of precision. So OY. Will the propeller just straight away turn from the axis of spin to axis of propeller? No, there should be some amount of couple that is acting, which change in its direction, which is nothing but an gyroscopic couple. So the gyroscopic couple will be acting in the upward direction. So OX is the axis of spin, OY represents the axis of precision, and this XY will us represents the gyroscopic couple that is making the aeroplane to take the turn. According to Newton's third law of motion, we know that for every action there will be an opposite reaction, is it not? So for every action there is an opposite reaction. Here XY is representing the active gyro couple. So obviously there is an opposite force which will be acting, which is not avoiding for that to happen, which is the reactive gyro couple, and that reactive gyro couple will be acting in the opposite direction. Now I represent this with y dash and x dash. So x, y represents the active gyro couple, x dash, y dash will represents the reactive gyro couple. What is the effect that is happening? Whether the aeroplane is just taking the turn? No, we have the vector over here. Imagine this is the plane and we have the vector. And this plane, the nose end and the tail end, it is taking a left turn, which is causing the nose to get raised, whereas the tail is getting dipped. So we can clearly observe that in this direction, we have the axis of spin and it is taking an axis of precision. If you consider this as the nose end of an aeroplane, it is taking an upward direction, whereas the tail is getting dipped. So for this condition, when the propeller is running in clockwise and the direction of view is from the tail end and the turn is left, what is the effect that is happening? So the nose raises, What happens for the tail? Tail dips. So this tail dips. So for the aeroplane, in order to take the left turn, the nose should get raised, the tail should get dipped. So this is for the first condition. What happens now if it takes a right turn rather than the left turn? The direction of view is similar. The propeller is running in clockwise direction. The direction of view is from the tail end. And the turn it is taking is in right turn. So for this, let us take the conditions again with the help of a thumb rule. Now, the axis of spin with respect to the observer is what? The propeller is running in clockwise. So curl it. It is running in the clockwise direction. So the vector is, the axis of spin is showing in this direction, the thumb. So represent that first. So OX, OX will represent the axis of a spin. Now, this has to take right turn. So what is happening? The axis of precision is not going upward as in the case when it was left turn. Now we are supposed to take right turn. The axis of precision is acting in the downward direction. So the thumb is indicating in the downward direction. I am supposed to take the right turn. That is represented by OY. Will it happen directly? No, there is some amount of gyroscopic couple that is acting, that is represented by x, y, and it is acting in this direction, that is in the downward direction. For this active gyrocouple, there is a reaction that is developed which will be acting in the opposite direction, that is denoted by x dash y dash. X dash y dash will indicate as the reactive gyrocouple, x, y will indicate as the active gyrocouple. Then what is the effect that is happening on an aeroplane? See, we have the aeroplane nose end and the tail end, and the aeroplane is taking an right turn. So the what happens for the nose? The nose dips, whereas the tail gets raised up. The nose keeps on dips and the tail raises. So that is the effect that is happening for this particular condition. So the effect is nose dips, whereas the tail raises, whereas the tail gets raised up and the nose gets dip. So for the condition of propeller running in clockwise and the direction is from the tail end, the turn is taking is a right turn, the effect should be that the nose should get dips and the tail should get raised. So this is with respect to the propeller running in the clockwise direction. Now let us make the propeller to run in the counterclockwise direction. The direction of view is from the tail end itself. If you want to make it in an easier fashion, just change the observer, but keep the propeller to run in the counterclockwise direction itself. So that will be, the vector will be in this particular direction. So we'll take a condition. So the propeller is running in the counterclockwise direction. The direction of view is from the tail end itself, and the turn it should take is the left turn. So where I am? I am here. How the propeller is running? Is it in this direction? No. If this is the direction, it is in the clockwise direction. Now what we are supposed to do for that? So we have a finger, it should run in the counterclockwise direction. The fingers swirl or curl in this direction. So this indicates the counterclockwise direction. Now what is the direction in which the thumb is indicating? That is towards the observer itself. That is towards the observer itself. So here the vector OX or the axis of spin will be towards the observer. OX. Now if this is the condition, which is the turn we are supposed to take? It is supposed to take the left turn. So this is the condition. The aeroplane has to take the left turn. So this slightly confuses. So what you do is change the observer from here to here. So if I looking from here, it will be in the clockwise. For clockwise, this will be my left and this will be my right. So based on that itself, the axis of spin going towards down in order to reach the axis of precision. So that is represented in the downward direction. So that is OY. So in order to make this happen, there is a gyroscopic couple which is acting in the downward direction. The XY will represent the gyroscopic couple. For this, there is an opposite reaction that is developed that will be acting in the opposite direction, that is represented by X dash Y dash. So this is the reactive gyrocouple. What is the effect of this? What is the effect of this on the aeroplane? So the condition comes over here. So what should happen? It is moving in the downward direction. So the nose should dip and the tail should raise. So write down the effect. The nose dips and the tail raises. So this is when the propeller is running in the counterclockwise direction and the direction of view is from the tail end, and the turn that is taking is a left turn. So the coming for the last condition, that is the propeller is running in the counterclockwise direction and the direction of view is from the tail end, and the turn that is taking is the right turn. So let us come from the tail end. The propeller is running in the counterclockwise direction. So curl your finger in the counterclockwise. The thumb will always indicate the direction in which the axis of spin is acting. So here represent it OX. Now the turn that it should take is the right turn. The turn that it should take is the right turn. The turn, the axis of precision is acting in the upward direction.
So represent that. OY. So for this to happen from OX to OY, we need a gyroscopic couple that is represented by XY and it is acting in the upward direction. For this, there is a reactive gyrocouple which is developed, which is X dash Y dash, which is the reactive gyrocouple. Then what is the effect that is causing for the aeroplane? With that we are supposed to identify and then write it down. The effect on the plane is such that the nose will get raised up and the tail will get dipped. So if you are just confusing, just change the observer. Just look from the nose end, you will get the clear picture of it. So the nose will get raised and the tail will get dipped. So these are the conditions that might exist on an aeroplane, where either the propeller is running in a clockwise or in the counterclockwise direction, or it could take the left or the right turn. So this is how a gyroscope will have an effect on its aeroplane. Now let us take an example, a numerical problem, and try to analyze the condition whether it should take a left or the right turn, or what is the amount of gyroscopic couple that is developed because of an actual condition in the given problem. Now looking into the first problem, the statement goes like this. An aeroplane makes a complete half circle of 60 meter radius left. So he is stating that it is taking a radius of 60 meter and the turn that is making is left turn. When flying at 240 kilometers per hour, it is stating the velocity in which the aeroplane is traveling, which is 240 kilometers per hour. The mass of the rotary engine and the propeller of the plane is 450 kg. So they have given the mass of the propeller along with the engine, which is of 450 kg, having a radius of gyration of 420 millimeter. So of 420 millimeter. The effect of this, the engine speed is 2000 rpm and it is running in the clockwise direction. When viewed from the rear end, which is very important, the direction of viewing is from rear end. So determine the gyroscopic couple and its effect. So we are supposed to calculate the value of a gyroscopic couple and its effect because of the given conditions. So for this, let us take an aeroplane first. So a simple sketch. So an aeroplane carrying a propeller and its tail end. So here, this plane is taking a left turn. This radius, what they have given is 60 meter, and that aeroplane is traveling with a speed of 2000 rpm, and it is running in the clockwise direction. Now let us try to take down the data from the given problem. So the aeroplane is making a complete half circle of 60 meter radius and the velocity is 240 kilometers per hour. So the velocity is 240 kilometers per hour. Convert this kilometer per hour into meters per second. How do we do that? So 240 kilo is into 10 to the power of 3 per hour into seconds. It is 60 into 60, that is 3600. So the value of the velocity in terms of meters per second is 66.66 meters per second. And the speed in which it is running is 2000 rpm and it is running in the clockwise direction when the view is from the rear end and it is taking an left turn. So the next data states that the mass of the rotary engine and the propeller is 450 kg. So the M value they have given is 450 kg with the radius of gyration of 420 millimeter, that is K or R. The K value they have given is 420 millimeter. Sorry, 320 millimeter. The radius of gyration value is 320 millimeter. So converting that millimeter to meter, the value is 0.32 meters. So the engine speed is 2000 rpm and clockwise when viewed from the rear end, we have highlighted the data. We are supposed to identify its gyroscopic couple and its effects. So we know that the gyroscopic couple in general is given by the equation, the gyroscopic couple will be equals to I omega omega p, where I will represents the mass moment of inertia, that is given by mr square, whereas omega represents the angular speed of rotation, that is 2 pi n divided by 60. The precision velocity is omega p, where the relation is v by r. We'll try to substitute and calculate the values of I, omega and omega p individually. So the mass moment of inertia I is given by m into r square or k square, where m is 450, k value is 0.32. So the moment of inertia value that we have obtained is 46.08, whereas the angular speed of rotation omega will be equal to 2 pi n divided by 60, where n is 2000 rpm. So 2 pi into 2000 divided by 60 will be equals to 209.43 radians per second, whereas the precision velocity omega p will be equals to velocity divided by r. So velocity is 66.66 meters per second that we have calculated, and the radius of turn that is taking is 60 meters, so the precision velocity is 1.11. Now substituting the values in the case of gyroscopic couple in order to determine its magnitude. So the gyroscopic couple is given by I omega omega p, where the I value is 46.08, omega value is 209.43, and the omega p value is 1.11. The gyroscopic couple that we are going to get is 10.712 kilonewton meter. This is the amount of gyroscopic couple that is acting for the given condition. But we have done with the calculation of gyroscopic couple. They have also asked us to calculate what is the effect that is giving for this condition. How to write the effect? We should remember the three parameters, in which direction the propeller is running is one condition, and the type of the turn that is taking, and from where we are viewing. So to begin with, the direction of view is from the rear end, they have mentioned in the problem, and it is and the propeller is running in clockwise direction. So here we are with the direction of view, and the propeller is running in the clockwise direction. So the fingers will be in this direction. So the thumb will indicate the direction in which axis of spin is acting. So this vector Ox will represent the propeller is running in the clockwise, and it is in the Ox direction. Now the other thing is which type of turn it is likely to take. It is supposed to take the left turn. In order to make it convenient, we have formulated a table for all the conditions that we have seen, where the first indicates the direction of rotation, whether the propeller is running in clockwise or in the counterclockwise direction, and the turn, whether it is taking the left turn or the right turn, and where from we are viewing, whether viewing from the tail end or from the nose end, and the what should be the condition on the nose, whether it should raise or lower, and similarly in the case of tail. Whereas for us in the given problem, the direction of rotation fixed for the clockwise. What is the type of turn it is taking? It is taking the left turn. So the direction of view is from the tail end itself. So what will be the effect? The nose will raise. So the axis of precision will be acting in the upward direction, or the axis of spin, and it has to take the left turn. So that is represented by OY, and the effect of gyroscopic couple will be acting in the direction of XY. There is an opposite reaction for this gyroscopic couple that will be acting in the opposite direction, that is represented by X dash Y dash. So what is the effect? The nose should raise and the tail should get lowered. That we are supposed to write. The effect is nose raises. What happens for the tail? The tail dips. So this is the effect for the given condition problem. Similarly, in the examination, they might change the parameters with respect to the speed, with respect to the direction of rotation, with respect to the velocity, with respect to the viewing end. So depending upon the type of condition given for the aeroplane condition, we are supposed to calculate the value of gyroscopic couple and what is its effect. So these are the type of problem that will be asked in the exam. Try to remember this table, which makes the job easier in order to identify the effect that is making on the aeroplane. So in this session, we'll conclude with the gyroscopic effect on the aeroplane and the problems with respect to that. In the next session, we will begin with the gyroscopic effect on the naval ship. Thank you.